Joe Montana free, Pat Riley free, Buster Douglas free, Super Mario GP free, or Collins free.
What Nintendo?
Buy a 16-bit Genesis system between now and October 31st and get an extra game.
Genesis does!
16-bit arcade graphics.
You can't do this on Nintendo. Genesis does!
16-bit sports action.
You can't do this on Nintendo. Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis does!
Get Joe Montana free, Pat Riley free, Buster Douglas free, Super Monaco GP free, or Collins free.
Nintendo.
Buy a 16-bit Genesis system between now and October 31st and get an extra game.
Genesis does!
16-bit arcade graphics.
You can't do this on Nintendo. Genesis does!
16-bit sports action.
You can't do this on Nintendo. Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis
does!
Genesis does!
Get Joe Montana free, Pat Super Monaco GP free, or Collins. Buy a 16-bit Genesis system between
this on Nintendo. Genesis does
16-bit. Section.
You can't do this on Nintendo. Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does.
Genesis does.
Pat Riley free, Buster Douglas. Monaco GP free or Collins free.
What?
Buy a 16-bit Genesis system between now and October 31st and get an extra game.
Genesis does.
How's it going, guys? Doing play some more Genesis for you guys. Transfer to level 8. figure out where I'm supposed to go. Oh, I think I know where I'm supposed to go now. Yeah, that was a mistake. Crap! Probably a worser idea. Yay. Getting pummeled by ghosts. Jeez. This is a bad idea. There's the exit too. Yeah, I knew that was going to be a bad idea. I'm never really good at Gauntlet. It's a fun game, though. Live stream if you watch. Heist, man. everybody says that, you know, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Turtles in Time is way better in this game. I like this game. I think it's pretty cool. Thank you. I was almost dead. I hate this controller so much. Like, I really want to get rid of this. Thank you. Hey guys. Comic fan? Actually my brother was more of a comic fan than I was. But I did enjoy like some of the oddball comics like Beavis and Butthead. And like the Ren and Stimpy, like video game comics were kinda neat. The Mask. Mask definitely was one of my But I did enjoy like some. So yeah. Anyway, back to some turtles. I know my signal's probably lagging a little bit. It's probably due to the SERP signal. Yeah, the Mask comic that I liked the most was The Hunt for Green October, I think it was. It was definitely a graphic Mask comic, in my opinion. Wouldn't mind getting, like, that series again on comic book. That'd be pretty cool. But, like I said before, the oddball comics, like Beavis and Butthead, like that series was kind of neat. My brother was more into the comics like X-Men, Spider-Man. He collected the trading cards as well. He had a huge stack of cards. I don't think he has it anymore, but he had a lot of good freaking cards in that. He had a giant binder-like thing full of like really good X-Men cards and stuff. They're really neat. Me, I was more into like the retro toys and games. That was me. Like, I'm trying to think of some. I was into some of the toys I had growing up. I had I still have it. It's one of those crash test dummy smasher doll things. Like, an example would be if you ever seen the movie Airheads. Pip uses the purple one. I had the white one. Man, I'm just getting beat up. Rocksteady. Another comic book I thought was kind of interesting, I think I still have it somewhere, is the, they made a Kool-Aid Man comic book. Got him. Yeah, I have I think I have an issue of the Kool-Aid Man comic book. I used to have, like I said, the Beavis and Butthead and the Mask comic books. For a while, I used to have, like, the really older comic books, like Tom and Jerry and, like, Chip and Dale and, like, those comic books, like the Walt Disney ones. I had a few of those. I had a few of the Pink Panther ones as well. Those were kind of neat. call it a day. I know it was kind of a short live stream, but I'm getting kind of hungry. And I'm lagging. Figure out why I'm lagging so much.